since I'm sitting here with the camera, I'm just gonna continue the story today. But I'm gonna, yeah, this is obviously a new video, you can see that. So. What happened when I came home? So I got home to Norway. It was December 2018. And I was like, how can I get in touch with different studios? Because I've heard that this process is not easy. It's not easy to get a foot in. And I was lucky enough to get all these opportunities by coincidences in Thailand. But I wasn't sure how I would go to the next step to get into a new studio. But it was impressed with that I was actually already having an apprenticeship, and I've done some work both on skin and silicone. So I had something to show and refer to other than just drawings. So I started to make this video.
You do not know who I am. But even though you don't, I'm about to ask you a favor that can change everything for me. I am an artist. At least in the vision I have for my future. I'm on my way pursuing my goals towards becoming a tattoo artist, but I know I will be in need of guidance to get there. I'm looking for you to take me under your wing as your apprentice. It might be a lot to ask for, but I still pray to whoever's out there that someone sees my potential and believe in my dream and ability to become an artist. And that this person can see themselves to be a part of my journey, shaping me to the artist they see I can become. One thing is for sure, I know what I want. And when I know what I want, I will do everything it takes to get there. And give whatever in return that can be in your favor.
This application where I was basically telling a bit about myself, but more about my process and my values and my intentions becoming a tattoo artist. And I was sending it around, and I actually got a lot of response, and that really made me happy. But mostly people already had an apprentice, or they were not taking in, but they say just continue, your work is amazing, you should try to, like, you will find someone to work with. And actually, before I went to Thailand for the apprenticeship, I was talking a little bit with Leading Light. I was asking them about the opportunities, and they say they can't guarantee anything because right now it looks like it will be available in January, but they can't promise anything in case there's coming anyone else in. So I sent them an email, but they straight away replied, sorry, we were already full, we have an apprentice that's starting up. And I was like, but at the same time I was talking to the artist before I left, and I was like, oh, I can't just send an email and just take it for a no. I need to actually go and talk to them and try to get in touch with some of the artists and not just the reception. So I found some of the artists on Instagram, and I started to talk to Emmanuel, which is the guy who has the main focus on realism. And I was talking to him. He looked at some of my work in the video I made, and he was like, you know what, I'm gonna talk to Jørn, which is the boss. And he talked to Jørn, and one day after, Jørn gave me a message, and he was like, hey, I've watched your story and everything, and I will try to get a meeting for you. And I was like, you're kidding me. Anyways, I was so happy, but at the same time, I was like, I won't expect anything. Before, we've been talking and like, see how it is. This is just an interview, and it can be many people that get interviews. So I went for this meeting, and we were sitting and talking, and I felt like we really got along, and I really liked his vision and work ethic, and he seemed like a really kind man. And when we talked, it seemed like he was quite impressed with my work, which I was really happy about. And yeah, it looked a bit bright, but still, I wasn't sure, but I had a good gut feeling. And then 1 week later, he called me and he wanted to take a new meeting. And since he didn't call and didn't like shut me off, I was like, there might be a possibility. So I left for this meeting, and then I remember he said to me, it was like, Oda, I have some good news and some bad news. And I was like, okay, what is this? And I remember he said, the good news is we want you on the team. I'll be talking to the other artists and the manager and everything, and we want to give you a shot. And They appreciated that it looked like I was working hard for what I wanted, and he was thinking I would possibly fit into the group. But then he said, but there's one bad news. And that is, we already got an apprentice. Normally we only take in one, but I want to give you a shot, but we cannot take you in right now. So you gotta wait a couple of months before you start, so the other apprentice could get like the main focus. And that was totally understandable. I don't want to come in there when people have worked their ass off to actually get that job. So I was like, that is totally okay, and I totally understand, and yes, I'm saying yes to the opportunity, and I was willing to wait. And then I remember going out of the office, and I was just feeling like this, like I was really happy, but at the same time I was like, oh, I want to start now, like oh, I don't want to wait. It was almost a half year that I had to wait. But then I remember my girl was just telling me, this is an opportunity for you to travel again. So I decided to go to Bali for a couple of months. And I actually got an opportunity to apprentice there while I was there, but I decided to go to India instead. Yeah, and then I came back and was the start of this. Yeah, I can tell you later about how it's going so far and what I've been going through the last 3-4 months I've been at Leading Light. So it's been a really, really good journey for me, and I'm really, really appreciative. But at the same time, I'm really happy for my work ethic and that I really work hard to get what I want. So yeah, we're on the right track. Do you feel the vibes? Do you feel the vibes?